So how do you want to do this? You want to maybe just play like a couple battles first, and then I can just be quiet while you're playing and kind of see what the baseline is.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so I'll do a couple battles. I'll explain what I'm doing, what my thinking process is, and yeah, see you on a play time.
Yep, sounds good. Yeah, that'll really help too. Yeah, don't be afraid of making mistakes either. That's how you learn. On the
So
all
I've two,
shiny
four, six,
team.
four, so it drops 40 points.
Oh, that's all
It's
good.
okay.
Yeah, I think there were a lot of people that I've been talking to that are running this team. They've had some troubles with like counters or the meta not being as good recently.
Well,
But
it's a good lead.
yeah, we got the good lead there.
Okay,
Yeah.
so should be two tap motion.
The video is a bit laggy, but that's fine.
Probably a squish bump, but I'll leave it. He's going to up a shield.
Yeah.
It's interesting. Gonna let this go. Let's get down.
Oh, that's not, that's unlucky.
Should win this.
Oh, it's gonna be so close.
Should have pushed kills from this range, isn't it?
I think so, especially against Shadow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. That was a good battle. Yeah, you played it a bit differently than I would have. I'm not sure what is better. But I think it might actually have to do with the IVs of your Typhlosion. My problem is when I switch my Typhlosion into Venusaur, if I tank a Sludge Bomb, they Vine Whip me down in the two shield. Unfortunately. Yeah. Whereas your Typhlosion looked pretty healthy. Like you could have won the two shield if you'd wanted to there.
That's not that great. 14 attack, 14 defense.
Yeah, I think mine is like 15 attack and almost zero defense. So that's probably what's happening is I'm
Okay.
just taking a ton of Sludge Bomb damage.
Would you stay with Harry and not do a close combat and then switch?
With Venusaur, I usually swap right into the Gengar right away, just because I feel like I can it's more comfortable matchup because you can let through whatever charge one of whatever charge move. Well, at least for me. For you can let through one of whatever charge move on Typhlosion for some reason, so. Yeah, so
That's
that was
interesting.
good. You managed to win against a Gallade in the back lines too, but oh, think we lost your screen
One
share.
sec, sorry.
There we go. Yeah, usually if I can guarantee Gengar a like a good matchup, Like if they if I win the lead and then they switch into something that Gengar can beat, then I usually switch him in just because Typhlosion has a lot better neutral matchups. Just in case there's, like, let's say you swap in the Typhlosion and then they have a Snorlax in the back kind of deal, then it's a bit tougher. But that, like, the thing is, it's nice watching other people play, just because everyone thinks of something differently, and when you start playing in a certain way, you kind of just keep playing in that way until you see something else. So it's always good to get a new perspective.
No, it's interesting because sometimes when I'm smarts in the back against Gengar, I just automatically quit because there's no chance of winning.
Yeah.
Unless they've had Focus Blast, but
Yeah.
this works on Shadow Ball.
Yeah, Shadow Ball's better for pretty much everything else. And actually, I've learned recently that from the other side, because I was running the Alolan Muk, but Shadow Ball Gengar can beat Alolan Muk. It does a ton of damage. I kind of just wrote it off as a lost matchup, but.
So for this one, I'm going to change Typhlosion again at the same switch.
Yeah.
Let me swap for that. And I normally shield and get to Solar Beam through the Blast Burn.
Yep.
Yeah, I love him. That makes a double shield there.
Yeah, it's really close. It really depends on how fast they swap the Swampert in.
It's just too spammy, Swampert.
Just Hydro Cannon. Yeah, Swampert's just such a pain to deal with. Well, they let it go down.
Strength came down.
Yep. We know it's coming back in. Oh, nice.
I can get a shield off him and kill Venusaur, so it might be okay.
Maybe.
I should get to Shadow Ball, I think. On the top case.
Yeah, it'll be down to the wire, I think. Oh, nice. And you still have a pretty healthy Hariyama too, right? So I don't know if you get to Heavy Slam
Shadow
before
Ball
the showcase,
counter.
but yeah, nice. Okay. I would just a couple things. Overall, the strategy is very good, and that's the most important part. If you're planning on letting Typhlosion go down in the one shield, which I think is fine too, like going one for one against Swampert is fine. I usually try and go two for two. But if you're planning on sacking, then just throw the Solar Beam anyways. I've seen a couple players not shield there, and it's really nice to get it. If you're not planning on saving the energy, then you might as well. I guess the advantage of throwing the Blast Burn there like you did is that they'll probably not charge up as much energy because they're scared of you getting to another Solar Beam. So it does make
Yeah, if you
sense to
shield
bait there.
Solar Beam, then they can farm a bit more knowing they won't
Yeah.
get to it in time.
Yeah, that's true.
But yeah, it makes sense to use Solar Beam. I was thinking, say, one shield for at least Gengar or Hariyama,
Yeah,
just in case.
that makes sense. Another thing to consider is when you see a Charmer in the lead is you. A lot of the time you don't really need a shield just because they already have one Pokemon that essentially doesn't have a charge move, I would say. Like Togekiss's charge moves are pretty bad. So having shields down when you have a Hariyama and a Gengar, I think, is more advantageous than whatever they can have or maybe that's not true, whatever they can have, but like Togekiss plus something else, it's probably better to try and just get the shields down in general. And then I also, this is something I've just noticed through playing, but I've noticed a lot of Venusaurs don't shield at all against Gengar, because they don't like the matchup very well. So I usually throw Shadow Ball versus Venusaur right away. Unless Venusaur is the last Pokemon and like you both have two shields or something like that. Because then I think you need...
Yeah. Shield matchup against Venusaur.
Yeah. The problem is if like they're saving the shield for something in the back, but I guess they you ended up burning it anyway, so it was good. We're off to a good start.
It is a little bit laggy on your side.
It's kind of laggy, now. Yeah, but it's not like I'm getting used to it. I personally don't mind, but. Okay, another pretty good lead here.
It's on four confusions now. So you might shield my focus past me.
Yeah, you gotta be careful of the... Actually, you even have to be careful of Leaf Blade at this point.
Shield this.
Yeah.
Farm down and Blast Burn while it comes in.
Yeah, you already know one thing on their team doesn't want a Blast Burn.
Plus Soul Beam as well.
Yeah, you can probably see what comes in. It's a bit risky, but there's not too much in the meta that can... Oh yeah, it's a Blast Burn.
So if he's coming out with Bomb Start, he must have something quite weak to Typhlosion as well.
I feel like that, but he might also be just trying to farm down. A lot of the times, I'll come in with something weak because I think I can like farm down, and then you can play around to switch after. Then you didn't quite like he would have just completely lost if we had gone to that Blast Burn. But nice.
Oh, maybe she went for the heavy slam first.
No, I think this is good. Because you have what do you call it? You have a close combat stored up now. And that should one-shot a Bombasnow.
Does Tyran win CMP?
It's close. Actually, I don't know. That's a good... See, that's the thing is, like, my Ultra League knowledge, like, on specific, like, move counts and stats is not nearly as high as, like, my knowledge in Great League, and that's probably why my rating is much lower in Ultra League than...
It should be okay, because I've got...
Yeah.
But, like, a weather ball should kill me.
No, I don't even think an energy ball would KO you. So I think you're pretty fine regardless. Wow, good start. I think that set was played pretty much perfectly there. Like, I'm sure there's something I was missing, like, in the small mechanics, but overall, that's exactly how I would have played that set.
I think I've been lucky so far.
Yeah, you've had some good leads, which is always nice. Well, second game was not a good lead, but... Yeah, but I've noticed there's been a lot of like anti-fighter leads recently. People have been absolutely sick of Machamp, I think. And Toxicroak is coming up in a big way. Also kind of an anti, like it's a fighter lead, but it's also an anti-fighter lead.
Five, six.
I might shield.
This.
Yeah, because he's at two thunder punches, so he's gonna throw two. Even if you shield a thunder punch, he's gonna get to the other one, right? So you're gonna have to shield one of them anyways. And I've seen a couple Ampharos just throw straight focus blast right at the beginning because that'll KO. So then you can tank one and then go in with your close combats here. Yeah, it feels bad shielding a thunder punch, but. That's good, I guess. And the thing is, Thunder Punch doesn't really threaten anything on this team either, so. Nice, two shields down. Oh my god.
Soul Beam coming.
Yeah. That was a brave switch by them.
I survived a surf, right? From him.
Yeah, you survive a surf. They must have something really weak to Typhlosion in the back.
Ooh, doesn't one shot kill there?
Wow, that's weird. Mine does, so I wonder if it's the 15 attack IVs. But that's good though, you get the extra extra little bit of damage there. Well. Yeah. I'm surprised he didn't just farm you down. Or she, I guess. Yeah, bring Gengar in. Hopefully they don't have like a like a Snorlax in the back or something. Yeah, there's only a couple Pokemon you'd lose to in the back, and I don't... Yeah, that's good. Yeah, the only Pokemon you would lose to in the back there, I think, is, like, some sort of Dark-type. So maybe, like, Honchkrow or Alolan Muk. Or Snorlax or Obstagoon. But I think your Hariyama... Oh, your Hariyama's really low, though, so... Almost at that Shadow Bunch. Nice. Nice.
Good start.
Good start, yeah. 4-0 is definitely a good start. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think... actually, I have played a couple times at this time, but... those are...
I'm getting all the Canadians.
Yeah, all the guys, all the drunk people, all the drunk Americans and Canadians are playing right now. Another good lead. So that's, I would say, three good leads, one bad lead, and one average lead.
So I'm going to try Typhlosion again. Oh, I should try Gengar.
Yeah, see how it goes next time, maybe. But, I mean, if Typhlosion's been working, like, I stopped doing Typhlosion because I expressly lost switch advantage against Venusaur a couple of times. And I've now learned that that's my IVs, which is extremely unfortunate because that's like a very common scenario. I would probably shield, yeah. As long, like, I think trading a shield for a shield is always, always worth it. And in this case, Lapras does do pretty good against Gengar just because it is tanky enough to kind of survive like a shadow, like more than one shadow ball.
I'm not going to suspend two shields.
Yeah, it's fair. It worked last time, so.
Yeah, I should get to Shadow Punch before him anyway.
Yep. I guess the other option is just tanking the Venusaur charge move and farming all the way up.
I might stay in. New Shadow Ball.
Yeah, we don't know what they have in the back, so. They obviously don't have a Snorlax or something like that.
Yeah, I'll let this go.
Charizard.
Do the Shadow Ball swap into Harry.
Yeah, I think that's smart. You might be able to counter him down. Yeah, there we go. Nice.
I don't know this, but I've not 5-0 with this team before.
Well, it's not 5. Yeah, it's pretty much 5. I was like, it's not 5-0 yet, but yeah, there we go. Nice. Well,
that's a bonus 4-1.
Well, I guess yeah, we're getting a bit lucky here with matchups and leads. Haven't seen a Snorlax yet, but like, yeah, it's whoa. What the, what is happening? Yeah. Why can't I get this for myself? I didn't even know GBL rewards could be shiny. That's pretty funny. That's amazing.
That's a lot of points.
Yeah, 5-0s are... Holy! Wait a second, yeah, that was also way more points than I expected.
Have they increased the point system yet?
I wonder if they did. I'll have to check Reddit after America wakes up, I guess, tomorrow, to see if that was the case. Holy. Do you want to get into another set, see if we can keep this going?
Yeah.
As far as coaching goes, I do want to take, like, a step back. Like, I don't want to be, like, micromanaging your decisions in-game. Like, you're already a very capable player, so I feel like I don't need to do that. But just in general, I don't want to micromanage decisions because I feel like there's no learning involved there, right? Like, if I'm just playing through someone else. Yeah, the last three games are pretty much, besides the swapping into... What? Okay, this is interesting. Yeah, very good lead, though.
Yeah, I'm not really sure to do it. Maybe Gengar. I mean, yeah, it's on Bjorn. He's Gengar.
True.
I've never seen on Bjorn before.
I have not either. I saw stuff about it originally on, in preseason and season one. It was ranked decently highly just because it's also pretty good against Giratina. But
I would shield this.
Did you get the debuff? Sorry, I was writing something.
Yeah, I got debuff, yeah.
Ah, shoot. That's unfortunate. Oh. They undercharged.
What do you think of Typhlosion far out here?
I think it's fine. It'll be close. But at least if they do get Octazooka, you can still shield and clear the debuff, but you're going to get him down anyways. Typhlosion is much better with energy than Hariyama is. Like, Hariyama is still good with energy, but if you have energy on Typhlosion, like, what swaps into a shieldless with Typhlosion? Yeah, I don't know.
I think that's like one far play and switch.
Holy, that does no damage! Oh my god, Umbreon. Okay. That looks like you'll just get there.
This might be close.
Nah, you're... Oh. Yeah, never mind, they've been Umbreon.
Umbreon's, CP is 2,100.
Yeah, it does not. Like, I don't even know if that's like a 100% Umbreon. See what charge moves they get to. They know they have to get to 2, so they're not gonna... Yeah, this is gonna be really close. If they don't have the next one charged, you're gonna win. They don't. Nice.
Counter,
oh, maybe. Oh, yeah, maybe this team is, like, specifically designed to beat the Caleb Peng team. As far as matchups and play goes this time, I think if you have a Pokemon like Kingdra or mainly, especially Kingdra, come in on Typhlosion, or, like, anything, like a Swampert or a lead that you would normally charge up to two close combats and throw them, I would probably do that as well. I think also just catching the Octazooka on Hariyama is nice too. And as long as the Pokemon that was switched or swapped out, like Umbreon, for example, as long as Hariyama still has enough health to deal with it later, then I think that's it's fine to charge up to two close combats. And because your backline doesn't really deal that well with Kingdra, like Gengar is okay, but like as you saw, if you get the debuff, like I hate percent chance debuffs. I hate them. They need to remove RNG from the game. But like you see what happens there, especially if like if you charge up to that close combat and then throw it and then switch out, then this Kingdra is probably almost out of Octazooka, and you really don't want that onto your other two Pokemon, just because like if you are going to get Octazooka, you want to have at least like built up to a Shadow Ball and thrown it, or a couple Shadow Punches and stuff. With charging up to a close combat, you give that Kingdra some time to charge up, and then once it has energy advantage, it's a lot harder for your backline. And then at the end, this is just a minor thing, but I think when you're in that situation with Typhlosion versus, Umbreon at the end, I think as soon as you see that Umbreon charging up, you know you want more energy on Typhlosion, so I would charge up some Shadow Claws and then probably swap out to Hariyama at that point, a little bit earlier. You did eventually swap after catching one, but I would just swap earlier, because if the Umbreon does throw something, that foul play, like you saw how much damage it did to Typhlosion, not very much, it would do like a third of that to Hariyama. Like it's just wasted energy on his part. So, but yeah, that was well played as well. I think it was helped out a little bit by the fact that they're running an Umbreon in Ultra League, but you know, late night battles or early morning battles. Yeah, I wonder where more people are playing from right now. If it's from the Americas or if it's from Europe, because it's like kind of just a really weird time in general. But, or maybe Asia.
Yeah, I don't really like Swamp Elite.
No, new team I'm running.
It's Shield 1.
Yeah.
The double close combat.
Yeah. Yeah, Swampert is not very good to see for the new team I'm running as well. All three Pokemon hate it. It just charges so fast, and Hydro Cannon's so strong.
You're doing quite well with this new team.
It's going okay. It's a bit more accessible and a bit more spicy, I think. No community day moves, so we'll see how it goes. But I do think this one is more fun, though. There's just so much more damage coming out of every attack. It just feels like every charge move you land just feels so good. It doesn't even matter which charge move it is.
Double shield. I don't like this guy. It's going to get to another one, isn't it? Trent, go to Gengar farm or Typhlosion farm?
It's up to you here. I would go Gengar, I think. You're going to have to probably deal with another Hydro Cannon here anyways.
Hydro Shield.
Oh. Oh my god, are you kidding me?
Yeah, I lost that.
Yeah, I think he lost this match as soon as it queued. I've never seen a double normal team before.
See how much Shadow Ball does.
I don't even know if you'll get the chance. Yeah, not very much. I think usually if they do double shield, I think, it's hard to remember, I think I bring in Typhlosion and just try and farm down and use the shield. It wouldn't have helped in this case, because I think as soon as there was a Snorlax Obstagoon in the back, it was game over. But swapping in the Typhlosion to farm down instead generally can bait out the Snorlax without them knowing that you have the Gengar. I know I said Gengar, but that was my bad. That was bad coaching. That was negative coaching.
We didn't know he did that on the back.
Yeah. Either way, that game was... I don't think that game was winnable, but... Unless they, like, severely misplayed. I guess every game is winnable, but... Yeah, Focus Blast. See, they're starting to do this a lot. Typhlosion. Yeah, I think that's a good plan. Yeah, I saw an Ampharos with Power Gem earlier today, too. And I'm just lucky I, like, randomly... I felt like shielding on the Typhlosion.
That's okay.
I didn't even know it could learn that move, to be honest. I don't know. He's charged up more than a weather ball.
Yeah.
It's hard to tell if something's lagging just because your screen is just generally lagging for me. So it's hard to tell when there's actual lag and if it's just like the FPS going through. Like I wouldn't say your screen is lagging. I would say it's more of just an FPS drop. Yeah, it feels like it's like maybe 20 FPS right now. It's normally not that big of an issue. It's just like when you're swiping the bubbles, it's very noticeable. Nice. Another win. One thing I'll say about that one is that I would, like when you have that Typhlosion at one HP left at like farm range, I would swap into Hariyama instead. Just because then you can build up to a close combat if needed, throw it, and then clear the debuff again. So you can kind of dance around that a little bit more. And then you also don't reveal Gengar yet. As soon as you show your last Pokemon, they have full knowledge of their team. And at that point, they'll know if they have a win condition, they'll know how to execute it. In that case, they didn't have a win condition, but they still had full knowledge, so they knew how to better deal with it. Luckily, they also swapped in their Abomasnow, so we got full knowledge as well. Oh my god, I hate Gengar. Dragonite.
I hate the Shadow version.
Oh yeah, the Shadow version's worse too. Actually... Oh. It's gonna be close, but I think so. Oh no, he had a bit of energy, I think. It's unfortunate, it's so hard to count one turn fast moves. Okay, now we're in a very bad position. Oh, and a Toxicroak. Yeah, they win the CMP as well. Okay, well, that charge move is going. So when they swap in Dragonite, or if they have a lead Dragonite, I would charge up to a close combat and tank a Dragon Claw, and then throw close combat. Because even against Dragonite, it's resisted, right? But it still does quite a bit of damage, and especially against Shadow Dragonite. This wasn't Shadow Dragonite, but if you are against Shadow Dragonite, you can swap in Typhlosion after the close combat hits, if it does hit, and you can farm down. And if not, then they use a shield and you can get to a blast burn and they'll use another shield kind of deal. It just puts them at like a good amount of HP if they shield or don't shield. Because if you swap in Typhlosion right away, they technically didn't really need to shield that blast burn because they would have probably lived. But if you have some counter damage in there first and then you swap in Typhlosion, they probably have to shield that blast burn. And likewise, if they tank close combat, you can probably farm them down with Shadow Claws with only spending. Actually, I think I've done that matchup a couple times. I think what ends up happening is you end up with a sliver of HP and like a fully charged Solar Beam for the next Pokemon or whatever, like Blast Burn, Solar Beam, whatever comes in. At least that's my Typhlosion, and your Typhlosion is tankier, so I think you'll have a little bit more wiggle room as well. I
If I
think.
did that, I would have won the Dragonite matchup, and then I would have won that match because it began against Toxicroak.
Yeah, that's rough too. It depends who has the energy advantage going into that. I think. What was their lead again? Lapras?
Lapras, yeah.
Yeah, that's tough.
It would have been better than that game anyway.
Yeah, I think it's winnable, but you still have to like play around a lot. With that, Toxicroak is something that just does really well against this team too, and it's getting more popular. So, yeah, I think I think when Dragonite won switch advantage there, and we didn't get shield advantage, that's when it kind of like it was all downhill from there. Yeah, sorry, I'll try and I'll like I've been sitting back a lot.
That's fine.
I've kind of forgot to maybe do some more input just. In terms of like not saying do this, but just things to keep in mind during the game as well. But you're playing really well. Oh, nice. Yeah, that's fair. I might have tanked an Aqua Tail first.
Makes sense, don't you? Now he's gonna have to tell Gengar.
Thankfully, that's not a crunch.
If he shields, he's gonna win this and win Switch.
I mean, he might have to spend two shields. You're gonna be very close to getting two.
Should I shield it?
I don't know. I think both are about the same. Because you can come in with whatever now.
If
I
you
would
go
probably
back
come in
out,
with Hariyama, yeah.
yeah.
Because you keep your team secret and you can throw a close combat. And well, once your switch timer's up, you can throw a close combat and then swap out. Oh, or a heavy slam in this case. Yeah, throw that heavy slam and get out of there. This is gonna be.
Can Typhlosion win two shields here against both of these Pokemon?
It'll be very close. Whoa! He let that through. Okay.
Double Blast Burn.
I would never shield the first Night Slash just because they might get the buff.
Shielding.
Okay. Yeah, this is gonna be very rough. I don't think you can beat Gramble.
Farm him down and get to a
Whoa.
move.
No, he's gonna, yeah, swap. That was unfortunate. Yeah, I think if you just catch the Aqua Tail on Hariyama, that one goes a bit differently. That's okay. That was rough at the end. 'Cause yeah, if you manage to like take switch advantage or keep switch advantage when your Hariyama is either or you know there's an Obstagoon or a Snorlax, it's really good if you can keep switch advantage. I know most of the time this team is built around shield advantage, but like I think that's the one case is where you see that there's a Pokemon that's extremely hard countered by either one of your two Pokemon or sorry. A Pokemon that extremely hard counters either, well, mainly just Gengar at that point, I think. That's fine. A 2-3 set's not bad, considering we jump, or you jump 90
Yeah, so
points.
we're still it's 50 points over on the first set. Do you think I would have won that if I shielded the first card slash?
I think he was charging up. I think he had two full Night Slashes charged up and he could have thrown them. So I think it wouldn't have really mattered which. Okay. So this could be a mirror match.
Using your team. What's the play do?
I have never played the mirror match before. We'll see. I would charge up to two close combats. That's probably what they're gonna do too, though.
We'll just shield first, right?
Yeah, I would throw. And usually in these types of matchups with debuffs, whoever throws first loses, but this is not the case because this will one shot regardless. And I would just throw spam that next close combat.
Hopefully he tapped his as well.
Yeah, that's the goal. Yes. Yeah, I would come in with Gengar because you can just farm down on this, and if it is a mirror, you have a two shield advantage and only Typhlosion and Shadow Claw.
Why
That you have to worry
not shield
about.
this close combat?
It could be a heavy slam, but I think it's just a close combat. Oh, it's a heavy slam. Okay, get to a Shadow Ball.
Mirror match. I won anyway because I've got two shields.
You should. Gengar is going to take a ton of damage here, but
Just switch out now.
yeah.
We should message this guy and say, guess who I've got on my phone. That's a good surprise there. Someone else is using the team.
Yeah, actually, there's been, it seems like a decent amount of players for some reason doing this. Actually, one of the people that I know is also using my team that I like message quite a bit. He's the one who helped me test out the Bastion double Razor Leafer team, Front Fight. He made the leaderboards with this team like 200 or something, and he said during those matches he also played another mirror. So I know there are some people, which is honestly kind of it's like it makes me a bit happy that like they're playing these
Their
teams
team is
better than I
probably
am.
top.
Yeah, like because. Like I admit, I'm not very good at Ultra League. I don't know the matchups as well as Great League, and like these charge move type teams are very new to me as well. So I'm learning as well. So it feels like I was kind of didn't want to release the video in the first place because, like I wasn't able to make leaderboards with it. I was hovering just below it. I wasn't sure if it was me or if it was the team or something like that. I would feel really bad recommending a team to someone and then having that team fail after they spend a lot of Stardust and candy and stuff like that, right? After releasing the video, having people have that kind of success is great. It feels good. Yeah, that was a perfect way to win that mirror, I guess.
Two back-to-backs.
Yeah, I don't know why they
That's
didn't try and throw their close combat earlier, because you guys should have both thrown your close combat or first close combat at the same time. And then like you would have CMP tied, you would have both got a close combat off, and then I think your Hariyama has higher attack stat. So you would have been able to get that second shield and then faint. So you only had a one shield advantage, but like a one shield advantage in this like on this team is pretty huge. And also being the first, like with shields down, being the first person to switch into the Gengar is huge, because once you get that one Shadow Claw of advantage, no other Pokemon on their team can switch in. Like, you are going to, like, Shadow Punch KOs Gengar, right? So you're going to beat the other Gengar to Shadow Punch, and you're also going to beat Typhlosion to Blast. Well, you're going to get to Shadow Ball before Typhlosion gets to Blast Burn. So that was a good start to that set. Mirror. Actually, yeah, I haven't seen a Mirror so far. It's only been other people. I don't know why. But I guess that's probably the best way to play that matchup. The other way I think that might be the better way to play the Mirror is to charge up two close combats, and after they throw the first one, you swap out to Gengar and catch the second one.
Yeah, I mean, that is interesting. So if this one catches Dragon
Claw, then what's combined? I don't think that's enough for a Hurricane, but I'm so bad at counting one-turn moves. Yeah, that's fine. You're going to be kind of low, but...
And then Typhlosion.
Yeah. Yeah, usually they'll swap, so this is good. I would always bait against Lapras, because if it fails, it takes exactly two Blast Burns to KO anyways. So if it baits and it fails, you don't really lose that much. So yeah, they call the bait.
Should I double shield there?
You could try, or you can even let this through, you'll survive it, I think. And then you could go for another Blast Burn. Either way, you're going to get a shield off of them. Yeah, if you double shield, you might be able to get two off. We'll see how much... What are they doing?
He's farming a lot.
Yeah, he's trying to farm you down, but you're... I think he's trying to get two serves. Oh, he's CMP tied with you too. I would let this go.
Don't hurry on, man.
Yeah, he might have two serves, but
that's fine.
That's fine.
Yeah,
yeah, two serves. And then this is good because you can just farm down with switch timer's probably up, but mm-hmm. They're gonna have to react pretty fast. As long as there's no Snorlax in the back, they actually let you farm them down.
Shield and farm.
I would, yeah, just to be on the safe side. Hopefully it's not a Snorlax or...
But he's got, like, Muk at the back. Well, Muk.
Oh, God. Okay, that's well, that's perfect. Yeah. Then this should be pretty straightforward here. Yeah, so I guess that just shows a little bit about, like, staying in that Dragonite matchup and tanking a little bit of energy. Like, I think that's the main advantage of using Hairy Ammo over Machamp here. Like, I think Machamp, just because Rock Slide is such a good move, is better in almost every scenario. But this team is so squishy, or the backline is so squishy, just having that... Like, Hairy Ammo is not actually that much tankier than Machamp, but it's tankier enough that you can take those... like really low damage charge moves like Aqua Tail, Dragon Claw, Octazooka, stuff like that. And you can take that move and you're kind of like a third shield for your team, because you kind of have to shield those on your other two Pokemon. And then as long as they don't have something that you need to take down with Hariyama afterwards, then you should be fine. But yeah.
If next people don't know the matchup as well, quite well against Hariyama.
Yeah, that's true. You see a lot of people shielding moves that really only make sense if they're expecting like a rock move like Stone Edge. I think a lot of people think Hariyama has Stone Edge for some reason. That's my guess. Because a lot of Dragonite shield it. Ugh. was a slowish switch from them too, I think.
So what would you shield and go for the solo bait then?
I would shield and go for the bait, I think. And then you can maybe take two shields down. And then I would go for the solar beam, shield and the solar beam. I think you can make it. It's really, really tight. It depends on how fast they switch.
I should be able to.
Yeah, if they're throwing hydro cannons as fast as like they can right now, you're definitely going to beat them to it. Yeah, they need one more, I think, mud shot for the hydro cannon. Because I think it's 5-4 and then 5. And then they shield. Okay. So just try to get to a blast burn and throw it. They're not going to let you. That's fine as well. You just come in with Hariyama. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is going to be very close because you can't take another one of those. I would just... Well, this is going to be close because I think they might be able to farm you down. I would swap into Gengar, like... Well, you won't get to switch. Oh, nice. So you get to Shadow Ball, I think, before because he was slow on the switch. Actually, I think it's pretty close anyways. And then you should be able... I think it KOs. Yeah. And then they can't really come in on anything. Like, what are they going to do? They have a Togekiss. This is actually going to be kind of close because you're not running Sludge Bomb.
I think I get to punch it after this.
Yeah, it depends if they get to their charge move. Nice. Okay. Whew. Yeah, those Swamperts are always sketchy. If they swap in slow, you can do that and either force two shields. More often, I've seen Swamperts let through the second Solar Beam, which is also fine because your team does not deal well with Swampert at all. But yeah, like shields down when they have a Charmer is just huge. If they have like something like Magnezone or Escavalier in the back like that, then Gengar can just take them down with that energy advantage, and you don't need shields with Gengar. It's like the best. What is it like? The best defense is a good offense. In that case, like you take them out before they get to the charge move. So yeah, that was good. I think that we played you played a very similar team in one of these earlier matches. I think with the Togekiss.
It definitely helped. The difference was that I shielded the shield attack motion.
Yeah. Yeah, don't be afraid to go all the way shields down, I think. Because I think coming into this, you had the mindset where you kind of want to save a shield for Gengar.
Yeah.
But I think it's more important to, like, trade shields or... Wow, what is this guy charging up to? Holy cow. Is he running close combat? That would be... Okay.
Should be nearly at two,
man. Yeah.
Should go to Gengar after this?
Yeah. I'm probably still going to Typhlosion, but I think that's fine too. It's like, this is the better play if they don't have a Snorlax. The problem is they might have a Snorlax. Alolan Muk, so this matchup's not as bad as you think. Throw Shadow Balls.
I can't really tank one, can I?
No, you can't tank anything. That does so much damage, actually. It's insane.
Should I shield and get another shield out of it?
I think you can just let yourself go down. If you have two shields, I would shield. Well, I guess going to Hariyama here. If they let the first Sludge Bomb go through, then... Sorry, the first Shadow Ball go through, then you can just like win with Shadow Claws after that, so you beat them to shields. Okay, so Typhlosion has to do some heavy lifting here. This is going to be a pretty...
Should I shield the charge move?
They have a Machamp. In the back, I wouldn't, or
Oh.
that's fine.
Well, which one's got energy? I think
That's
I'm
true.
fine there.
It'll be, we'll see if we can get, oh my god. Oh, so close. Yeah, farming down the Alolan Muk is really hard with Shadow Claw, but you actually almost made it. I think that was probably your best bet, because I think that's your only win condition.
That's what it is, yeah.
Yeah,
I've got Blast Burn. He's got Shield.
you have to throw two Blast Burns here. Oh, he let it through. Oh my god, okay. Yeah, you
Not
have to
getting
hope he
Shield.
doesn't shield. Yeah, that's your only hope. And I don't even think your Typhlosion one shots Lapras's. So no, that's a good play. That's something I also fail to do a lot, just personally. I always go for the bait, even though my only win condition is them not letting through the bait. That's something that's very tough for me.
Yeah, even on beta, I don't think I could have got to solve it.
Yeah. No, even if you bait it, you wouldn't have got there, but like that's what I normally do. That's like one of my biggest flaws, is I do that a lot, even when I really should just be throwing the move. Yeah, I think that's okay.
Shadow Dragon then.
So annoying.
It does so much more damage.
Yeah, it does. You can still tank a Dragon Claw, but you're going to be left a lot lower. Then we'll see if they tank this close combat. Oh. That's fine. You have slight shield advantage. We'll see if they go down to zero shields here.
I should shield this.
Yeah, I would shield it. It always feels bad shielding a Dragon Claw, but you kind of need to take out this Dragonite. They double shield, you might be set up depending on what they have in the back. They don't. Oh, Toxicroak. This is.
Isn't good.
Nope. That's
Shield
unfortunate.
and
I wouldn't. Just because look at energy off of you, I'd go in with Gengar. And then try and build up to a Shadow Ball and bait. And you have to shield. If they let it through, you might be able to farm down anyways. I think Shadow Punches is good enough. Oh, they swapped in Lapras.
Hariyama's pretty dead though.
Yeah, Hariyama's.
What would I try and catch a serve? Hariyama.
Yeah, I would try and catch as well.
Three.
Make sure you have
Oh,
it. Oh.
is it four? Four eye shards.
Yeah,
Or
it's
five?
four, I think.
I find them here for some reason.
That's all good. Oh, that's gonna be close. Yeah, I don't think this one is winnable at this point. Team is just very strong. Wait, was that Dragonite? Lapras Toxicroak? I think that's
Yeah.
FP Styx's team or something. So you might be running into a decent amount of that. Yeah, that was unfortunate, but
If it cut that serve or stack swapped it, you might have won that one.
yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think you're thinking five because five ice or sorry, five ice shards is icy wind. So you might be thinking like
Oh, okay, yeah.
the Articuno or Cloyster or Dewgong matchup. Because that's like another really common one, right? Well, like Icy Shard Surf is only common for it's only on Lapras, right? Whereas Ice Shard Icy
It's
Wind is on
flammable.
everything.
Flammable is an ice beam as well. Mazu.
Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah, five is the magic number for yeah, five mud shots for a Hydro Cannon, right? Yeah, I think that's well, you probably have to go to work soon, right?
Well, I don't start till an hour and a half. I work from home.
Okay.
You have to go to bed?
We can probably do one more set, I think.
You want more snack then?
Yeah.
Are you recording these still?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, tech. Well, we just hit the 1 hour mark, so I guess a lot of discussion and stuff like that between games, so. that makes sense. Because these games are pretty fast in general, just because as soon as shields are down, Pokemon start fainting on whichever side.
See, a lot of Ampharos leads.
Yeah, Ampharos is, like, I always thought Ampharos was kind of weak, just because I think this team does pretty well against it. Mainly, like, Harry, like, everything seems like it can tank a Thunder Punch. But it seems, I don't know, it's just very consistent damage. And Electric is not a very resisted type. Just because ground is so garbage. They swap out.
Should I save one?
I would save one, yeah. And then I would swap into Gengar if they let it through for sure. Yeah.
Don't shield the fancy plan.
I would let one through, yeah. Yeah, if you can take one, then let it through. The only time I would be cautious if your Gengar doesn't have very good IVs and it's in the two shield.
Oh,
they got to another one. Let's hope you didn't CMP tie.
Shield.
Yeah, I would shield. Oh, perfect two.
Could have found down there,
Jack. I think so, but this way you might be able to farm down and get a shield. No, that's fine.
We still got two shields.
Yeah, this is a bit rough.
It's fine, it's still before the Thunder Punch.
I wonder if you'll be able to farm down or if they have another one. Oh, yeah, throw close combat before you faint. Or are you going to get two? It's going to be close. I would...
get two, I think. Sure.
Yeah. It depends if the fast move is going to go through. Go to another one. You might just faint. Oh, yeah. Close. Yeah. It's hard for me to see these kinds of things because your like screen is very low FPS to me. So it's hard for me to tell if like that... the fire spin animation has gone through.
I think I needed one more counter.
Oh, you weren't even at the...
Oh, well, when I built up to two, I had two, but then... When I did the first one, I needed one more counter.
Yeah, because I thought I saw it was, like, fully charged, but I guess that's
just
the one. Yeah, so unfortunate for start for this one. I think in... general with Hariyama, if they do swap out of that or to Venusaur, I would probably just swap right away as well. I wouldn't throw a close combat just because just because like the two Pokemon you do have in the back have very dominating matchups against Venusaur, so you don't need that additional damage, and you can save that for well, Ampharos obviously at that point is like a one hit KO. They have to shield or they faint. And then Charizard can't take two close combats either. So.
Okay.
Well, playing an X rank 10 here. Snorlax lead. Very uncommon, but pretty ideal for this team. And they're going to go right to Charmer. So I would swap out right away to... Yeah, either... Honestly, if they're swapping to a Charmer right away, it might just be double Charmer. Yeah, getting your Gengar out of the way here, though, is pretty good. I would charge... So against Snorlax, I would just charge all the way... Charge past the Shadow Ball. And then you can fake the Focus Blast as well. And you might get a shield.
I'm not sure how many Shadow Balls and April Focus Blast.
Yeah, I'm not sure the exact number either. I just do a ton. I've been able to get... So, for example, if I do get locked into a Snorlax matchup, which doesn't happen that often... I'll charge all the way up, like pretty much all the way up, and then I'll throw shadow punches. Kind of, I'll throw one shadow punch and then bait. So yeah, go into the Hariyama. The problem is here you're gonna have to. Yeah, I would shield this first one. Let's see what it, because it could be an earthquake. It's just a bison. Oh, they're gonna swap. Yeah. No, that's fine. This is fine. I think Snorlax is gonna be the harder Pokemon to take down. I think. Close combat is going to be a bigger deal. Snorlax double fairy. I've never seen this before. So they're going to throw shields, actually.
Shield.
Yeah, I would shield against Togekiss. Yeah, if he gets the boost, this is just very unfortunate. I'm not sure if you're going to get to another Blast Burn, actually. This is going to be... That's true, but then the Snorlax is going to give you some issues. It's going to be very close. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Okay.
That was close.
Do you think close combat one-shots this Snorlax?
So.
You might not get to find out. I would throw... Yeah, now. Because the problem is if he gets the two charge moves, then you're in a bit of trouble. Right. Nice! Oh, that game was very scary.
Is that type of motion at the end?
Yeah. I'm just barely getting to it. I would have... I would have lost that game, I think. But... Yeah. Yeah, I think losing the health on the Hariyama is a big deal when there's a Snorlax able to farm down the Gengar. The other thing I might have thought about is swapping in Typhlosion first, just because then they might blow shields early. Because, like, oh my god, morph Charmer every game. Yeah, Typhlosion immediately. Sorry, what was I saying? Interesting.
He's locked in now.
Yeah, he is. Ooh. Oh my god. Yeah.
He can't.
Yeah, because you have your fast move got through, as well. So even if he does have two, he's gonna faint beforehand.
That's interesting.
What? Gengar. This is like a bastardization of this team. But this is also gonna be very tough. If you can get to that, oh no. I would maybe swap in Hariyama, honestly. Just because. Yeah, I would Hariyama for sure until he clears his energy and just charge to a heavy slam. I wouldn't shield. Don't shield Hariyama. Hariyama is useless right now because he has Clefable as well, remember, so. Oh no.
I can get some heavy slam. Should I bait?
I wouldn't, but I would overcharge. So maybe, yeah maybe try and.
That's the shield, right?
Yeah, but he might just let it down and save the shield for his Gengar. Yeah, that's fine. Just farm down. You're fine. Shield and farm all the way down. Unless he can switch in. Yeah, you have to get to two Shadow Punches here in the farm down. And he has to not already be at a Shadow Punch. Okay, so just spam that Shadow Punch button and hope. Yeah, he did. Like, he really farmed on that Hariyama, though. Like, he had a lot of energy. I just... Okay, he didn't have quite enough. I feel like he was, like, one or two Shadow Claws away. It was very close. Nice. Oh, that was scary. I thought that was going to be a much easier game, and then all of a sudden Gengar came out in the back, and like, I don't even know what to say about that. Yeah, the thing is with these Gengar mirrors is whatever Gengar goes in first has a really big advantage. If they're both running Shadow Punch. But yeah, I think we played that as well as we could have. The other thing is, actually, no, we could have played that better, but like that takes a lot of thinking in the moment. What we should have done is immediately when Gengar came in, we should have swapped to Hariyama, I think. Because then Gengar doesn't get to, I think Gengar got 5 Shadow Claws farming down Typhlosion, and then instead of that he would have just swapped out to Clefable instead, and we probably could have gone to a Blast Burn versus Clefable, or they would have had to throw their energy kind of deal. So it'd been a win-win. But that's like, that kind of stuff is really hard to tell during the game. It's a lot easier to look back, and especially me, I'm not playing, right? I'm just watching. It's so much easier for me to see mistakes, not mistakes, but like different things you can do in the game like that when I'm not playing. But yeah, we can go to the next one, I think. Yeah.
I would never thought about drawing again.
Yeah, like identifying useless Pokemon on your team and just like sacrificing them is very important. And like we identified it and sacrificed the Hariyama, but we did it later than was optimal, I think. Like we could have played that better. It worked out, and I'm glad it worked out, but like we could have done it better.
This is good bait.
Yeah. Perfect.
So close combat and switch.
Yeah. Charizard is the only one that I don't really like catching a charge move on Hariyama because they usually charge up to a Blast Burn and you really cannot take a Blast Burn. Also, Typhlosion deals really well with like tanking either of these charge moves. I wouldn't shield. A lot of the time they bait Dragon Claw and Blast Burn does more damage, so they're smart, but you outpace them now. I guess they can go to Dragon Claw.
I think they've got Togekiss at the back.
You think so?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. I would shield this. Winning switch advantage is very important then.
Because I think my friend uses this team.
Oh, really?
I could be totally wrong.
Well, it's fine either way. I would double shield then. You have energy for another move. Abomasnow absolutely cannot take a Blast Burn if it's Togekiss in the back. They really don't want to take a Blast Burn either, and then you'll have switch advantage. Oh, it's Gengar. This is really not ideal then. And then, so your Gengar will faint, unfortunately, if you go in with Gengar. I think you still have to go in with Gengar and then swap and try and catch the Shadow Punch. Is that a Shadow Punch already? We'll see if it faints. I actually don't know. I've never been in this scenario. Okay, get to your Shadow Punch. Not quite. No worries. I don't think he would have gotten to it. And they're probably just going to get to a Shadow Ball here.
Yeah, I don't know if I would have got to it.
No, I don't think he would have gotten to it either. I don't think that's a mistake. Yeah. Unfortunately, one fast move away from being able to win that game. All right, last battle, I guess. Yeah, we kind of went all in on that that shield strategy there. So
yeah, I didn't say anything. I want to save the shield.
Yeah.
Against the Gengar back.
Yeah, because at that point you can come in with your Gengar, and then farm down the the Charizard.
Yeah.
Oh, a Dragonite lead. We'll see what it is.
We won the other one, didn't we?
Yeah. I think we lost the Shadow Dragonite lead. But I think we won the regular one. All right, so they let it through.
Shield and farm.
I think you can just let it through. I think, at least with my Typhlosion, you can, and then you farm. And this ends up being really, really, really close. Yeah. Yeah, your Typhlosion has a lot more health than mine. So we'll see what they swap in, and we can probably get a shield from whatever it is. I think it's fine. I think Blast Burn is fine. On my Typhlosion, I have to go straight for the Solar Beam. But on your Typhlosion, you can get the shield, and I think you get to Yes, okay. Oh, that's good. Wow, this just shows how much IVs matter, I guess. Holy.
Yeah, I think you needed that one.
Yeah. And then, yeah, come in with the Harry and just farm down. You have two shields, so. You can tank. Well, actually, you can't tank a Surf right now. I kind of forgot you were solo.
Try shield and go for close combat. I'll leave it.
I think either way is fine. You leave it and then come in with Gengar. And just hope that they don't have a Snorlax.
That was quick.
I would shield this and then just farm all the way down. I feel like if you had a Snorlax, you would have swapped already, right? Toxic Croak. Okay. Did you go ball?
Yeah.
I think ball's fine. Because you had a huge energy advantage. Oh! Okay. So this is FP Sticks team, by the way. This is the second time we saw it. Last time we lost. So what did we do differently? Oh, their Dragonite let through the close combat. So when the Dragonite lets through the close combat and you swap into Typhlosion, like, it's very winnable at that point. Because you can either just farm down or they bring in the Lapras.
It wasn't Shadow as well.
Yeah. Yeah, that it probably does. It makes the farm down harder for Typhlosion, but like on regular Dragonite, like, it's a lot sketchier, but your Hariyama has a lot more health to deal with the Lapras later. Okay, I think that went pretty well, though.
Yeah, 3-2,
papa. Yeah, 3-2. Yeah, 5-0, 3-2, 2-3-3-2. So, one negative set, but I think we're all just learning. Like, I definitely still don't play even my own team perfectly, right? So, and a couple of these, like, coaching things is kind of hard. Like, I need to figure out a better way to like, get the full FPS over or something like that. I wonder if there's... Yeah, because there's just sometimes where I'm like, I see, or I thought you had, like, for example, one time I was 100% sure you had two close combats stored up, and then you were one counter away, and that was the difference between a win and a loss, but.
Well, I think there's probably like a paid out there that does it, but.
Yeah, I use Visor when I was streaming, but it's kind of, it feels like it's like a virus almost, like it operates like one of those very cheap programs, you know, and it's like the resolution isn't as high as the Zoom screen share. Oh, maybe that would be something to do, is maybe turn down the resolution or something. I don't know, I'll have to experiment with it in the future, but yeah, thanks for doing this was fun.
So okay, no, cheers, Rafa. Yeah, and next time I do that, try and set some prices up and hopefully definitely shipping towards it.
Oh, awesome. That would be awesome.
Yeah, because I want to get to rank 10 this season.
Yeah.
On the first season, I went to 2950, and then I boxed it on the last day.
Oh, no. Have you not been rank 10 yet?
I'm not being rank 10 now.
Oh, wow. Okay. I thought, like, I just assumed you're at, like, 2500 right now. That's like, so in...
The first season I boxed it, the second season I didn't play Ultra League.
Oh, I see.
And the last season... On the last day, I got to 2,900.
Oh.
But then again, for some reason, I couldn't make it. And so much pressure.
Just so close, yeah. Well, hopefully this season you can. Yeah, because, like, you're a very good player. Like, I'm kind of surprised you haven't been ranked 10 at least, like, once in the past, so.
Yeah, I'm hopeful with your help, I should be able to this season.
Yeah, I think so as well. But, yeah. Yeah, thanks for this, and hopefully we'll do this again soon.